Obviously, water is a major problem in the bathroom, and it can again lead to scalds if the temperature of the water is too hot. The greatest danger of the bath is from drowning, and children will drown in just 2 or 3 inches of water. If the water will cover their nose and mouth, then they can drown. Children should never be left unsupervised in the bathroom. They shouldn't even be supervised by an older child. The problem often is that parents get called away to answer a phone or to answer the door. They think there will only be a moment, and that moment could be the moment when their child drowns. The conversation will often take longer than you anticipate. So pick the child up, wrap the child in a towel, and take them to the door or the phone with you. Medicines and chemicals will lead to most of the visits to hospital. Luckily, a lot of those are false alarms, but parents do need to be sure that they keep anything that could pose a threat to their children out of their reach, preferably locked away. One of the biggest advances in safety has been the success of child-resistant caps on things like chemicals and some medicines, but parents do need to be aware that they are only child-resistant, they're not child-proof. So you can't over-rely on those caps, but they have helped to cut down the number of poisoning accidents. We would hope that parents would keep their own medicines out of the reach of children, but of course they do need to remember that they will sometimes have relatives staying with them, perhaps a grandmother, grandfather, who will bring their own medicines with them, and they may not realise the danger because children aren't around them all of the time. So it is a good idea, obviously, to have a medicine cabinet that you can lock things away in.